Do not despise the chastening of the Lord. Do not despise the discipline of the Lord. Because listen, just as a loving father would discipline his own child, the Lord too disciplines his children. Those who go astray, he will discipline them to save their lives, to save them from the pit. So many of you who are going through a lot of problems, it could be maybe God is disciplining you. He's loving. He's so caring that he does not want you to perish. Because if he leaves you just like that, you will perish. Scripture says, there's a way that seems right to a man, but the end thereof leads to death. So there are a lot of people who are on a way that leads to death. And God does not want to allow them. He does not. He is always willing to save you. So do not despise the chastening of the Lord. Today's word is from the book of Hebrews 12, 3 to 11. Hebrews 12, 3 to 11. And it reads, "For consider him who endured such hostility from sinners against himself, lest you become weary and discouraged in your souls. You have not yet resisted to bloodshed, striving against sin, and you have forgotten the exhortation which speaks to you as to sons. My son, do not despise the chastening of the Lord, nor be discouraged when you are rebuked by him. For whom the Lord loves, he chastens and scourges every son whom he receives. If you endure chastening, God deals with you as with sons. For what son is there whom a father does not chasten? But if you are without chastening, of which all have become partakers, then you are illegitimate and not sons. Furthermore, we have heard human fathers who corrected us, and we paid them respect. Shall we not much more readily be in subjection to the Father of spirits and live? For they indeed for a few days chastened us as seemed best to them, but he for our profit, that we may be partakers of his holiness. Now no chastening seems to be joyful for the present, but painful. Nevertheless, afterward it yields the peaceable fruit of righteousness to those who have been trained by it." Glory to God. Do not despise the chastening of God. Now the scripture starts by saying, "For consider him who endured such hostility from sinners against himself." Speaking of Jesus, that he endured such hostility. He endured hostility from sinners against himself. Now the Bible says, "Lest you be discouraged and weary." Do not despise. Now listen, the scripture speaks to you as to sons, that do not be discouraged of the Lord is chastening. Some of you are going through terrifying things, and you have cried out to God. You have asked God why that is happening. But could that be the Lord chastening you? The situation that you are going through, could it be that God is trying to put you on the right path? Because maybe in the past you were so comfortable that you did not have time for God, that you did not have time to listen to his word. So do not be discouraged when you are rebuked by him. For whom the Lord loves, he chastens. When you receive chastening, discipline, it is an indication that God loves you, that he cares for you. Just like as a father, your human fathers, some of you as you were growing up, you had parents who disciplined you, who chastened you. And some of you can even testify that it was good that you were afflicted. It was good that you were chastened. It was good that you were disciplined. Because many of you right now would not be alive if it wasn't your parents' correction. I know as you are growing up as a young kid, you think that your parents are making you suffer. But most of your parents, not all, because there are some who do it in the wrong way, but most of them, they mean good for you. It is because they love you. It is because they have grown up and seen that if you continue in that way, it will lead to death. So they discipline you to bring you off that road that leads to death. Same thing with God. He's so loving that he does not want you to perish. We all know this popular scripture that says, for God so loved the world that he gave his own begotten son, that whoever would believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. God loves you, brothers and sisters. If this is an indication that even he gave his own son that he could save you. Some of you are still alive because God is still speaking to you. He still wants you to change. He wants you to change of your ways. It does not matter what you have done. It does not matter what you have done a few minutes ago. It does not even really matter what you have said. What matters is what are you going to do about it? Who are you in Christ Jesus? You have to reach at a point to realize that you are now a son. That it does not matter your past sins. Only if you can come to him and repent. And repentance is a change of mind. If you are walking towards a certain direction, you change and go onto the direction, onto the road that leads to life. And Jesus is life. Well, brothers and sisters, I have come to encourage you that no matter what you are going through, know that God is with you. Whether it is you are being disciplined, know that God means good for you. And all you can do is to continue being obedient to the voice of God. Is to continue glorifying him, worship him like never before. And things will be well for you. It will be well with your soul if you trust in God with all your heart, with everything that you have. Well, until next time, Shalom.